It's a perfect day for an exciting game of sock race. And the dust bunnies have been busy. Wow, that's a big pile of socks. Hello, yellow and red. Do you think you've won the race? Awesome. But what about the other team? Uh-oh, looks like pink and green also think they've won the race. Oh, both the sock piles look similar in size. How will the bunnies decide who won the game? Aw, don't worry, little ones. To see which team has won, all we need to do is learn about data. Any collection of facts, numbers, names, figures, or descriptions of things is called data. Data can be used to make decisions and even guess what might happen in the future. For example, your progress report from school has the data of how you are performing in each subject. While visiting a supermarket, you'll see that each item is labeled with the name of the item and its price. This is also an example of data. Hey, you know what? Data can come in different forms. It can be photographs, paintings, or even the different colors used in a painting. Looks like Pink is reading a book with math concepts. Just like this book, any essay, story, or book made up of thousands of words is also an example of data. Great, let's start counting. In yellow and red sock pile, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. There are 5 socks in this pile. Now let's count how many socks are there in the other sock pile. Let's see. There are 5 socks in this pile too. Both teams have collected the same number of socks, which means you all are the winners of the sock race. Hooray! Looks like the little ones have solved their problem. Now, they want you to look around and find more examples of data.